U.S. stands out as the only nation in the world to develop three different stealth fighters. But there's a problem. There's room for only two stealth fighters in the U.S. Air Force fleet. One of these fighters has to go. Would it be the F-22 Raptor, the best air superiority fighter the world has ever seen? Would it be the F-35 Lightning II, the world's most intelligent fighter? Or would it be the brand new 6th-generation NGAD fighter still under development? In this video, we'll find out the answer to this question and see which two fighters will emerge victorious in this inner battle within the U.S. Air Force fleet. Torn between two critical options, the U.S. Air Force has a huge dilemma to solve. The service can either prepare for a seemingly impending war with already existing technology, or build a completely new generation of technology. The earlier option would see the F-22 and F-35 5th-generation fighters constantly upgraded to match and surpass the challenges of the modern battlefield. The latter option would see the new 6th-generation NGAD fighter developed and put into service to counter said challenges. Both options have their appealing merits. Older technologies are tested and better understood. They offer the advantage of familiarity, proven performance, reliability, and established supply chains, effectively utilizing existing resources and infrastructure to ensure that the Air Force is well-equipped for war. Newer technologies are usually significantly more advanced. They make the Air Force more powerful to handle near-peer threats that older technologies might be inferior to. With Russia and China getting more near-peer by the day, advancement in capabilities is almost non-negotiable. Still, the decision of which option to go for ultimately boils down to how much of an upgrade the new fighter would bring, and if the existing fighters can match up close enough to these upgrades. To know which is the case, all three fighters must be placed under the microscope and compared. For a spot in the Air Force fleet, the F-22, F-35, and NGAD fighter, these fighters on the same team must now battle it out across the most battle-deciding categories, particularly stealth, avionics, and weapons. Stealth. Stealth is an advancement that has been here only one generation of fighters ago, but it's one that's here to stay. It began with the F-22 Raptor. The Raptor paid a perfectionist level of attention to the tiniest of details. It hid hinges, shaped its airframe, cools its leading edges, dresses in lavish radar-absorbent material, and features flat-thrust vectoring nozzles to mitigate the threat of heat-seeking missiles by reducing infrared emissions. All of these and more combined to give the Raptor an impressive radar cross-section of 0.0001 meter square, the same as that of a steel marble. The F-35 Lightning took some lessons from the Raptor, and as a good student, added its own twist. It aligned its edges, serrated its skin panels, and masked its engine with easy-to-maintain fiber mat skin. The F-35 manufacturers reduced its infrared and visual signatures, enabled the reflection of radar waves, and used strict controls of radio frequency emitters. All of these and more combined to give the F-35 a radar cross-section that's lower than that of a metal golf ball. While the Raptor still manages to have a generally better radar cross-section than the F-35, the F-35 Stealth would compare favorably in some conditions. The F-35 Stealth technologies are also more durable and easier to maintain. The NGAD fighter is expected to build on the technologies of both the Raptor and the F-35 Lightning. In addition to conventional stealth features, the fighter would take an overall triangular shape and have no vertical stabilizer, the first fighter in history to have such a design. Neither of the two 5th-generation fighters can boast of this, nor can they be economically edited to wield such a stealth-boosting, groundbreaking design. Avionics. The F-22 has an avionics suite that consists of the AN/ALR-94 electronic warfare system, the AN/AAR-56 infrared and ultraviolet missile launch detector, the AN/APG-77 active electronically scanned array radar, and an electronically scanned antenna. To lower interception probability, the Raptor's radars change frequencies more than 1,000 times per second. The high frequency enables it to double as an electronic warfare system by overloading enemy sensors. Radar, communication, navigation, and identification information are processed into a combined tactical picture to enhance the pilot's situational awareness by two Hughes Common Integrated Processors, each capable of processing up to 10.5 billion instructions per second. To keep all of these systems running, the Raptor software has an encyclopedia-long 1.7 million lines of code. Despite the impressive avionics lineup on the Raptor, the F-35 is still considered the most intelligent fighter in operation today. The fighter's avionics suite that includes the AN-APG-81 active electronically scanned array radar, the AN-ASQ-239 Barracuda electronic warfare system, the AN-AAQ-37 distributed aperture system, the AN-AAQ-40 electro-optical targeting system, and the AN-ASQ-242 communications, navigation, and identification suite enables the fighter to sense data at lightning speeds and from the greatest distances too. They provide rapid beam agility, multiple operational modes, all-aspect missile launch and target tracking, 10 radio frequency antennas, all-aspect radar warning receiver, self-defense against missiles, hostile radar detection and jamming, laser targeting, forward-looking infrared capabilities, long-range IRST functions, and an impossible level of sensor fusion that give the pilot and friendlies an omnipresent tactical picture of the battle space without compromising stealth. The F-35's avionics run on 8.6 million lines of code. That's 500% more than the Raptor. The NGAD fighter would once again build on previous technologies and exceed them. In the same program building the fighter, new unrivaled sensors and avionics systems would be built. The fighter would also feature an electronically configured smart skin integrated into its fuselage, doing away with sensors housed in radars, as on the F-22 and F-35. This results in improved sensor sensitivity and seamless communication that enables the NGAD fighter to gather information from unimaginable distances and share this information with friendlies in real time. Weapons. All three fighters are designed to hold their payloads internally to maintain their stealth profile, although they can carry weapons externally for increased capacity. They're all also designed to be armed to the metallic teeth. The F-22's armament combination consists of the Mach 4 flying AIM-120C advanced medium-range air-to-air missiles, Mach 2.5 flying AIM-9 Sidewinders, and the 1,000-pound class GPS-guided joint direct attack munitions. The fighter has an M61A2 Vulcan 20mm rotary cannon with 480 rounds embedded in its right wing route. In total, the F-22 has a payload capacity of 22,000 pounds. That is over 20% more capacity than the 18,000-pound capacity of the F-35. Being the fighter that must provide top-tier close-air support as it retires the legendary A-10 Warthog, the F-35 wields a 180-round 25mm GAU-22A4 barrel rotary cannon. This gun is more effective against ground targets than the 20mm cannon carried by the F-22 and lower-generation fighters. The F-35 has multiple internal and external weapon stations to carry a combination of air-to-air, air-to-surface, and anti-ship missiles, including the AIM-9X Sidewinder, AIM-120 AMRAAM, AIM-260 JADM, AGM-158 JASSM, the AGM-179 JAGM, AGM-158C LRASM, and so on. The NGAD fighter would be the largest of the three fighters and so would have the greatest payload capacity. It will wield a wide array of guns, bombs, missiles, and laser-directed energy weapons. Of these, laser weapons are the most headlining. They have unlimited magazines as they can continue to fire for as long as they're connected to power sources. They also strike targets at a speed of 180,000 miles per second, the speed of light, the fastest thing in the universe. In addition to these on-fuselage weapons, the NGAD fighter will be protected by Loyal Wingmen drones being developed in its program. The drones, known as collaborative combat aircraft, would also be integrated with the F-35, but not the F-22. And this isn't the only way the F-35 has an edge over its fifth-generation rival. At a cost of $350 million, the F-22 Raptor is quite expensive. It is the most expensive fighter in history and is over three times costlier than the F-35. And although the Raptor remains the best air superiority dogfighting fighter in the world, with its super cruise capabilities, super maneuverability, and insane 65,000-foot service ceiling, the world has moved on from dogfighting. Dogfights are gemishly rare, with only a handful of them happening in the last five decades. being able to take out a target before the target is even aware of foreign presence has become the order of the day. And in that, the F-35 triumphs massively. It's also significantly easier to upgrade the F-35 thanks to a level of open architecture that the Raptor lacks. Upgrading the Raptor would usually require extensive weeks-long surgeries on the fighter. In light of all these, it appears the era of the Raptor has simply come to an end, and it needs to be succeeded with an air superiority fighter with the modern requirements of the modern battlefield, hence the NGAD fighter. And it appears the Air Force agrees, as the service plans to retire the Raptor by the 2030s, once the NGAD fighter is operational in sufficient quantity. The F-22, F-35, and the NGAD fighter are crucial assets to the U.S. Air Force that could keep the U.S. far ahead of the competition. But with limited slots available, the F-22, the fighter that changed the world, would now have to make way. To honor it and to give it the hero's goodbye it deserves, subscribe to this channel and give this video a like. Thanks for watching.